The Creality CR10S that I got from my sponsor Gearbest is the upgraded version of the CR10, a printer that I have reviewed before. Same as its predecessor, the 10S ships almost fully assembled. There are minor scratches on the black anodized aluminum surfaces being visible only when having a very close look, nothing that affects the functionality. After unboxing you must mount the frame of the X and Z axis on the base plate with the Y axis. Wiring is also done quickly since all cables are labeled and have plugs with protection against reverse polarity. In the build instruction I could not find a drawing of where to place the filament sensor, however there is only one way to mount it near the extruder. There is a tiny board on the plug of the filament sensor that has to be removed to get it connected. The filament holder is mounted on top of the box of the electronics. Finally you can put the rubber decorations on the aluminum bars of the frame. All in all, the assembly is done in half an hour. Same as at the CR10, the movement of the print bed along the aluminum bar of the Y axis is guided by 6 rolls. Once more I have removed the 2 center rolls since 4 points are more easy to adjust than 6 of them and as you can see, the center roll is a bit loose out of the box. One roll of each pair is on an eccentric nut, so that the distance between axis and aluminum bar can be varied. With the 2 wrenches that are part of the package you can adjust the contact pressure. There is wear on the plastic rolls while moving along the rough surface of the anodized aluminum, so a bit grease on the rolls as well as on the notch of the aluminum bar keeps them in good condition. All in all those plastic rolls are in operation for a couple of months now on my CR10 and they still look fine. So this is nothing to worry about. The inside of the electronics box looks very tidy. The power supply is cooled actively by a fan, the output voltage is 12V at up to 30 amps. 2 more fans keep the temperature in the electronics box low. The power MOSFET switching the heated bed is on an extra board, a perfect solution. The mount of the deflection pulley at the Y axis is now made of metal, you can adjust the correct tension on the belt by moving that clamp. The tension on the belt of the X axis is also adjusted by moving the deflection pulley. The Y axis with the build plate, as well as the X axis with the printhead moves smoothly along the axis, the mechanics is really good. One of the upgrades of the 10S is the second stepper motor on the Z axis, so that both ends of the X axis are now driven through spindles. At the predecessor there was only one spindle drive used, resulting in vertical movement of the X axis at the free end during operation. As you can see, that error is now eliminated, only when having a very close look you can see the indicator move for less than one scale. You can transfer print data using G-code files on a microSD card. Before turning the device on I have adjusted the print bed to a low position. After turning the power switch on, the info screen of the printer menu appears and as you can hear, the fans of the 10S are less noisy than those of its predecessor, which was extremely loud. With a dial switch you can command all axes to their home positions. Adjusting the printer starts with bringing both ends of the X axis to the same height. I am using a distance piece printed from PLA having a height of 82 mm. After another homing of the printer, you can level the build plate. With the printer menu, you can automatically drive the printhead to the four mounts of the build plate, which simplifies the leveling procedure clearly. The leveling itself is done as usually by lifting the build plate with the knurled nuts step by step. Until nothing but a sheet of paper fits tightly between nozzle and print bed in the final run. The printer ships with a small spool of white PLA. Before inserting the filament, the hot end must be preheated to 185 degrees Celsius. As soon as the target temperature is reached, you can insert the filament at the extruder motor until a strand of plastics exits the nozzle. Two sheets of adhesive paper are part of the package to keep the objects sticking on the print bed, however I am printing directly on the surface of the glass plate. To get a good adhesion of the PLA on the glass surface, I'm using a glue stick. The heated bed of the CR10S is insulated on the bottom side. The maximum temperature is limited by software to 135 degrees Celsius. With a low environmental temperature of only 13 degrees Celsius in my photo studio, I get 60 degrees after 10 minutes. And 90 degrees Celsius after 25 minutes, which I would call the maximum temperature the bed can reach. You will get 100 degrees Celsius in a room with higher environmental temperature, but no more than that. Time for a first test run. I am using the file cat.gcode that is stored on the microSD card that came with the printer. The CR10S starts the job as soon as the target temperatures of print bed and hot end are reached. The layer height of the CAD is set to 0.2mm. The inner structures are printed with 55mm per second, the outer parameters with 35mm per second. The CR10S has resume after power outage. Here I pulled the plug to test that functionality. As soon as the electric power is up again, the question whether or not you'd like to resume the print appears on the printer screen. When confirming with yes, print bed and hot end are heated up to the target temperatures. As soon as those temperatures are reached, the print head goes up a couple of millimeters, and X as well as Y axis are driven to their end switches. After that, the print is resumed. A plastic knob is visible on the surface if the power outage happens while the print head is on the outer perimeter. Next I will check how the filament sensor works. As soon as the printer runs out of plastics, the X axis is driven to the end switch and after that, the Y axis is homed as well. Unfortunately, the firmware turns off the heated bed when running out of filament, which might cause your objects to get loose. After feeding in new filament, which should be done promptly to avoid the bed from cooling down, you can resume the job through the printer menu. I'm using bronze colored filament to visualize where the change in filament appeared. The filament sensor is a very useful upgrade of the printer. You don't have to use a new spool each time you start a larger project. After approximately 2 hours, the print is finished. After cooling down the heated bed, you can remove the CAD from the glass plate. The result is really good. All details on the surface, especially the tiny characters, are clearly visible. Besides the plastic knob, you can clearly identify the layer where the simulated power outage happened by a ridge running around the surface. Well, power outages occur rarely here at the center of Germany. More important is the transition between the two filament spools, and that looks perfect. Next, I'd like to check what print quality the 10S delivers when creating something more useful than sculptures. Here I'm printing the chassis of a new robot that is currently under development. It is also meant to be a printer test, which is why I have implemented needed support structures into the design. The edge width of the bridging posts is only 4mm and they look as straight as they should be. The layer height is set to 0.2mm, the print speed of the outer perimeters is 30mm per second, that of the infill 60mm per second. With a length of 195mm, a width of 106mm and a height of 75mm, it is the largest part of the robot. 120 grams of filament are needed for the chassis. After approximately 17 hours, the job is done. At the overhangs of the front window, you can see that the airflow isn't perfect. The fan blows on the edge of the printhead. So I have redesigned that part using open S-cut. The layer height of the print is set to 0.2mm. Now the air hits the tip of the extruder nozzle. Next part of my new robot is the mechanum wheel. It's composed of a rim having 11 tiny rolls. The diameter of the rolls is 20mm with a thickness of only 2mm. The diameter of the rim is 55mm. All rolls look good and the pieces of 1.75mm filament used as axis fit perfectly into the holes running through the rim at an angle of 45 degrees. Last part printed for this review is the rear undercarriage of the rover needed to mount two servos. The dimensions of this part are 85x58x23mm and same as all other parts, it is printed with a layer height of 0.2mm. The results look really good. There are no gaps in the surfaces, the characters on the chassis are clearly readable and there are no strings. The mechanum wheels work fine. All parts fit perfectly and that's what is needed when doing prototyping with a 3D printer. The CR10S is a sturdy machine with really good printing results. I definitely like the device. All upgrades make sense and result in an even better printer than its predecessor. The second spindle drive on the Z-axis eliminates vertical movement of the X-axis and there were slight improvements in the printhead design. Leveling the bed is simplified by the new firmware and finally the filament sensor will save one or the other of your prints. The 10S is definitely a printer I recommend to buy. You can have a look at the full resolution snapshots of the prints I made with the 10S and get the 3D files on my pages. Thanks for watching and I'll be back.